Well, good afternoon, family. Definitely want to introduce to everyone Miss Benet. I thought of the scripture quickly for today right now. It's Matthew 7:7-8, which we're all familiar with. You know, it says, "Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be open to you. For everyone who asks receives. He who seeks finds, and to him who knocks, the door will be open." So Benet has been looking, searching for God, searching to be able to have a relationship with God. And God, in his infinite wisdom, brought to her Matt Navi. Yeah. They were sitting at the DMV, you know, and just killing time, and they saw Benet, and they reached out to Benet. Wow. And Benet was so eager to meet and study, and here she is today, when it'll be our sister. So I'm going to let the women share. I'm going to let Charlotte share right now just a little bit about Benet.
Like Jenna said, Navi had met Benet, so when I first met Benet, she was like, "Okay, Charlotte, who are you about? I want to know what you're about." And what I admire her about her so much was her boldness. You know, she always had lots of questions when we were studying, but she said, after she wrestled, she said, "At the end of the day, I want to make the word my standard."
Amen.
So I'm just so grateful for her heart, for her hospitality. Me and her have become great friends, and just praying together and sharing our lives. So I do want to share a scripture because it's just amazing to see her growth. And she did mention in one of our last studies with her that she was sharing with her friend, "Well, that's not in the Bible." So I do want to share the scripture in Psalm 68, verse 11. It says, "The Lord announces the word, and the women who proclaim are a mighty throng." And Benet, you are that mighty throng. And I'm so happy to see you make Jesus work.
Has totally captured my heart. Just her generosity, her humility, just who she has been, her questions, like Charlotte said, she's just true Ethiopian eunuch, even though she's a woman. She just keeps coming, and she just keeps questioning and seeking, and her humility to be taught and to be given information, she's just hungry for. So
come on.
We love you for that. It was awesome studying with you. It's just been wonderful knowing you. And I'm happy that you're in my life. I do want to share a scripture with you, Psalms 27:4-5, and I hope that you will continue in the way that you are. But it reads, "One thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord and to seek him in his temple. For in the day of trouble, Benet, he will keep you safe in his dwelling. He will hide you in the shelter of his sacred tent, and he will set you high upon the rock."
I have Benet share.
Come on, Benet.
Good morning.
Good morning.
What's up, sis?
I really don't have anything else to say. My sisters took my verses. I told my story. I wanted to tell the story about DMV. They told you how I asked a lot of questions. You already know me.
Yeah.
I would have said the exact same things that I have written on this paper.
Aww.
I do want to add that this is the most important day of my life.
Come on.
For those of you that don't know me, I have 3 sons. Will my sons please stand?
What?
Will you please stand, sons? Where is Jesus? He's here, right with me, standing beside me. Again, I say, this is the most important day of my life.
Come on.
We trust you that you always, always. Alex is a play son that I've known his mother since he was born. Thank you for coming out. I love you.
Alex.
I was first baptized when I was 13. I've always known that I'm supposed to be a good person and not use alcohol and not drink and not have sex before marriage.
I like this one.
All of that stuff didn't work out.
Okay, I like her. I like her. I like her. I like her.
I thought I was a good Christian until I met my sisters here.
Amen.
Okay.
I have a lot of gold. I was always helping people. My parents taught me to forgive. But they told me I wasn't a Christian. They showed it to me in the Bible.
Yeah, they did.
They showed me the things that I needed to do to become saved.
Come on,
they showed it to me in the book. God, my point is, God sets us up for us to be where we need to be.
Yeah.
Getting back to Natalie Nabe and Department of Motor Vehicle. I knew I was missing something. I was moaning for years for this closeness that I have with God. I needed to become closer. So she took my verse, Matthew 7:7. Seek and you will find. I've been seeking God. But 6 months ago, 5 months ago, he set me up. I lost my Department of Motor Vehicle driver's license. So I had to go to the Motor Vehicle Department to get my driver's license. I didn't want to go. I didn't want to go to Hawthorne. You had to wait in line 2 hours.
Yeah, that's it. Amen.
I called every Motor Vehicle Department 50, 60 miles away. I had to go to Hawthorne.
Yeah.
I didn't want to go that particular day, but I had to go.
Right.
God was setting me up.
Yeah.
I get the DMV, and I sit beside Nabe. God had me to sit there.
Yeah.
He knew what he was doing.
Amen.
Yeah. I started talking, Matt Asher. Her husband. Then I started talking to her, his wife, Nabe. And I told her I just need a good Bible class.
Yeah.
So desperate. I need somebody to know. I'm so embarrassed, I said. I need somebody to start from the beginning. I'm old, but I need somebody to start from the beginning because I'm embarrassed. I don't know how to understand your Bible. She assured me. Do that for me.
Yeah.
I went to a Bible class the next night in Compton. And this is how I got here.
Yeah.
My sisters helped you. They have taught me well.
Amen.
They have counseled me. They came into my life and they told me that I had to get rid of my man. That I love, that I've been with 9.5 years.
Wow.
They didn't only tell me that, they showed it to me.
That's it.
Yeah. Oh, very good.
Because we were not married.
Yeah.
That is why they told me I had to get rid of her. Of him, and they showed it to me in the Bible. They also told me other things. What did you guys say? Okay. In conclusion, I would like to say that they kept asking me, do I understand that the cost that following Jesus is going to cost me? Have I counted the cost? Yes, I have. I've counted the cost. I truly have. God has set me up for this day to be in this church, and I can see it. He started setting me up a long time ago. And I grew up ready to follow him. I'm coming out of here. Well, my sons, they're not here. I'm coming out of here. I don't have to worry about anything else. He's going to pay my rent. He's going to put gas in my car. He's going to take care of me when I go to the hospital. He's going to... I'm ready. I'm willing and able. Yes, I have counted my cost, and I'm glad I'm here.
Amen.
Nate, do you believe that Jesus Christ came to earth, lived a sinless life, died on the cross for your sins, and resurrected on the third day?
Yes.
What is your good confession?
Jesus is God.
Oh, I'm sorry.